Today class we discuss about the advanced custom formatting. What is the method of the advanced custom formatting? So here, last class we discussed about the custom formatting, why use the custom and how can use the custom formatting, what is the benefit of the custom formatting. So now we discuss the some tricks of the custom formatting. So I started, last class we told you, if you want to apply any prefix and suffix before your number, so we have used the custom formatting. In the custom formatting, we have just typed here your text, just like MRP. I want to MRP 1500, right? But this is the text. I have not do the any calculation with this value because this is the text. But I want to show like that, but actually number is the number because I want to do the calculation. So go to the custom format, custom, and we have entered here MRP in the inverted comma. Because MRP is the text, so we have entered the inverted comma. And if you just click then OK, show only for MRP. If you want to show any type of the your numbers, need to insert your 0 and hash. Then your number will be seen. Okay? But I think we have also minus number, that's like 800. So I want to, if you have number in the positive, then show the MRP. If the number have the negative, then show the discount. Okay? So we have put here semicolon. So in custom formatting, we have the four palaces. First is the positive, second is the negative, third is the zero, and fourth is the text. So we have entered, this is the first position. So directly covered with positive and give you the semicolon. We have type here discounts and zero. This is the negative number. And we have put the inverted comma. In the inverted comma, a discount. Then second is the zero. Zero is the free. And fourth is the tax. Not empty, not available. So we have entered here four places. First is the MRP, second is the discount, third is the free, and fourth is the. So first position covering the positive number, second position covering the your negative number, third is the zero, and fourth is the text. So just press OK and you can see. I have typed the number, so the MRP I have in the minus. So discount, I have write the zero, it's free, and give the any tax, the empty. It is clear, sir? What is the benefit? I have just calculated the biometric attendance. I have received the data from our HR team for the biometric data, which person have how many times use the thumb expression or your and his access card. Okay, this is the bio. So this is the name or this is the scan time. So I have used the pivot table and I make the one attendance sheet like that. This is the pivot table. In future we have discussed the detail with pivot table, but now just see here. And we have, this is the our data, but I want to not a number, so not a number in this sheet. This is the attendance sheet. In this sheet we have the data in the numbers. Yeah, Pooja is second, first June, just scanned two times in and out, and Kavita second June scanned the four times. So your access card, need to open your door, use the access card. Okay, how many times you can use the access for opening your door? We have received the number of times number here, but I have just convert positive number to present and zero is absent. This is the blank. Blank it means zero. So first we have replaced blank to zero. So select my data. Go to find and select. And this is the replace. We have a space and this is the zero. And replace all. So blank replaced to zero. And now we want to convert in a positive number convert into B and zero convert into A, A for absent, like that. So we have used the same method, format cell, custom, and here is the semicolon, and we have not negative number, so keep it blank and give the A for absent. And also we have not have the any character, and then we also keep it blank for the your characters and just press OK. You can see here number convert in the positives and zero convert in the negatives. You can also, you want to color, I want to color red color. If you have a absent is the red color, so highlight by red. You can also the condition formatting, but you can also here number, give the square bracket red. Now if you press the OK, now your A is colored by red. Okay, it is clear, Mr. Kishtan? Okay, but I must what I want to color my data as per conditions, like we have enter greater than 100, then color red, less than 100, color green. You can also give the condition here. Go to the custom formatting and square bracket, give the color green, and also give the square bracket, give the condition, and here is the semicolon, give the another color green, and give the also conditions is greater than 100. And okay, now I have right. One is the green, one is the red. I give the wrong interior green. Red. Okay. I have type number. Give the red. And if that greater than green, but you want to more and more color and conditions, then we use the condition formatting. And the condition formatting topic we have discussed tomorrow classes. So now we have discussed the custom formatting. So in the custom formatting, we have two classes we discussed. In the custom formatting, we have different course and tools for the your data, showing the data is different. Just like I want to enter your company name. Company name is before every company, before insert the before company name MS, and after that we have write the company. So M/S is the typing for difficult, so I want to automatically cover. So we have used the custom formatting, write the M/S, and we have right here @, because zero is the zero for the number, hash for the also number, and @ for the text. Just press OK. we have write any name here. It's just like IPT. Just press the enter. You can see here automatically insert the M/S. Like I want to like enter your address. So we have enter your address. I want to my city and my PIN number is the same work for all address. So we have just like enter here @ new Delhi 110062. So just press OK and any type of the address enter here. After press and after the pressing enter, you can see the your city name and PIN number automatically added. You can also convert in the past. Just like we have typed the data, or this column is the password. So I want to your text convert in the password. So go the custom formatting and type the two character, only for two character here. So if you have typed any number, convert. Convert in the address. But see here, I just type the character. Character is not convert. So we have type here semicolon. We have right here negative, positive, zero, also address. Now your character convert number also convert the character, and character also convert the character. Right, sir? This is the custom formatting method. Now time to be, make the some projects. So I want to create a form. I give you the only one projects, one homework. So go to the home, go to the Google and search the form. Okay, go to the image and see the any form, any type of the form there. Like that I have choose it like this form. I want to form like same. So please screenshot and so you have created this type of the form in the Excel sheet, and also same features. If you have typed the name, show the name, and if you have blank cell, show the first name, last name. Also we have applied the password facility like that. If you have entered any password, password convert in the star. Okay, Mr. Krishnan. So we have created this, and tomorrow we discuss about the conditional form.